What's up, guys? Jimmy or Chaos, welcome back. And in this video, we're going to talk about what we think is going to be the best score streak in Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. You're watching some Defender Uplink gameplay from Optic Midnight. Link in the description to her channel. She goes on a couple good runs here. So enjoy that. She's running the KF5 Sporter, which is a really dirty SMG. So you guys enjoy that in the background. And we're going to run through these score streaks real quick, and I want to know which one you guys think is going to be the best one, the go-to score streak. And it's pretty obvious, everything's leaked out. Charlie Intel has an article about them. We're not going to show any pictures of ones we're not supposed to or anything like that, but we're going to go over them. So the UAV is the first one, and we know most of the modules with this thing. It has a ton of them. You can get extra assist points, scrambler, extra time, speed, enemy direction, threat detection, orbital support, all kinds of stuff. You could even build an orbital VSAT out of the UAV. So I think that one's going to be used a lot. But I think a lot of people are going to make the mistake of trying to go too hot. I think they're going to try to attach too many things on their score streaks, and they're going to end up not even getting to them at times. That's just my opinion. We'll see. The recon drone looks like it's going to be back, and there is no information about it. My best guess is it's going to be like the drone from Modern Warfare 3, where you could run around, that little annoying thing that you could tag enemies. Nobody wanted to use it. I mean, not most people didn't want to use it. I hated it when I got it, so we'll see if this one's any different. We don't know any of the actual attachment modules that are going to be on that one. Orbital care package, this one's going to be really interesting for the fact that you can run support on this thing and actually get at, you can do a support attachment where you actually, your points toward it stay with you after you die. So basically anybody would be able to get a care package before the match is over. There's double tap where you can reroll, and better odds where you have a better chance of getting a high level streak reward. I think the care package is going to be used a lot as well. It's not confirmed, but looks like some kind of assault drone. Maybe something like the Dragonfire from Black Ops 2 or something like the Griffin, something like that, where you could probably control this thing and fly it around. Don't know much about this thing at all, just the verbiage of it. And then also the system hack, which is on the list, and I know absolutely nothing about this. My best guess is it's going to be some form of an EMP, if that's what it actually is, and you would be able to maybe disable all the enemy's radar and electronic stuff like that. But that's nothing confirmed on that, so that's complete speculation on my part. The remote turret, which we know most about, you're going to be able to get it, and a lot of modules with this thing. You can turn it into a rocket turret. You can turn it into a direct energy laser turret. You can rip it off and run around with it. You can turn it into a sentry turret where you don't have to remote control it. All kinds of stuff with this one. It also, I believe, has a support module that may go with it as well. Then we have the Vulcan, the big laser beam from space. This thing looks pretty cool. You can actually like get an extra burst and increase your energy beam, stuff like that. A lot of people will give that a try. I don't know if it's gonna be that popular though. Also one that has been seen but not confirmed is the missile strike. Could be just like a group of missiles that comes down. Don't know much about that. The bombing run, which could be like a strafe run. Modules where you could add like an extra bomber to it, or care packages, or go stealth where they can't see the bombers. Could be like the Warthogs, I believe it was, from Black Ops 2, with that annoying sound. So we'll have to see about that one. And the last three are the Warbird, which I believe is a remote-controlled aerial attack vehicle with guns. Pretty sure that there is a module on there where you can get a wingman to help you out with that, or you can add rocket stuff like that. And then the Goliath, which we all know about, and you can add homing rockets, trophy systems, stuff like that, recon, the big suit. And the last one, the big one that most of your big players that are going for high KD and high kills, is the Paladin, I think is how you call it. It's a gunship. And this one has attachments like laser-guided rocket, a wingman where you can put somebody in there with you to tag enemies, and a big fat 105mm cannon. So we'll have to see what else comes out, guys. Like I said, the ones that I don't know anything about, they're not confirmed or anything. They're just on Charlie Intel as names. And we'll see which one actually reigns supreme. Let me know which one you guys think is going to be the most popular. Me personally, I know the Paladin is going to be popular in the Goliath, but I really think people are going to use the crap out of the orbital care package and the UAV. I strongly feel that way. So we'll have to wait and see. Thanks for watching. As always, guys, drop a like, and I'll see you later.